A warm good morning to one and all. This is Ayana Vijay
and this is Avina Vijay.
We are from Standard 10 of St. Paul CEHS Kuliachara.
As we all know that today, September 16 is celebrated as World Ozone Day.
So, why do we celebrate Ozone Day?
It is to create awareness among the people on the need of conservation of ozone and to control the product that causes ozone depletion.
It has been celebrated since 1994 and was established by United Nations General Assembly.
First of all, let's look what ozone layer is. Our atmosphere is divided into different layers such as troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, etc. The ozone layer is seen in the stratosphere at an altitude of about 10 kilometers. It absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays from the sun and prevents it from reaching the earth. It contains high concentration of ozone molecules. That's all about the ozone layer. Now, let's discuss the chemistry behind the ozone layer. Oxygen is a diatomic molecule. That means it contains two oxygen atoms in it. But ozone is a triatomic molecule which contains three oxygen atoms in it. The ultraviolet rays from the sun, which have high energy, decomposes the oxygen molecules into two oxygen atoms. This oxygen atom combines with oxygen molecule to form ozone. Ozone is again decomposed into oxygen atoms and molecule by absorbing the ultraviolet rays. As a result of the cyclic process, the amount of ozone in this layer remains constant. The energy for this whole process is received from the ultraviolet rays from the sun. Therefore, this harmful ultraviolet rays does not reach directly to the earth. It gets absorbed by the ozone layer. But in 1970s, scientists discovered that humanity is creating holes in this ozone layer. Most of us use ACs, refrigerators, etc. in our home. But the thing that we have to note is that the chlorofluorocarbons, halons, etc. are arising from this.
ACs, refrigerators, different types of sprays, fire extinguishers, paints, etc. are equipments which contain dangerous gases such as CFCs, halons, etc.
These dangerous gases would remain unaltered in the atmosphere for a long time. Then it goes to the upper atmosphere and reacts with the ultraviolet rays. As a result, chlorine and bromine is formed. The main thing is that chlorine is capable of destroying 1 lakh ozone molecule. Bromine is 40 times more reactive than chlorine. If all these gases come to the ozone layer, what will be its condition? As a result of this, the thing happening is that the ultraviolet rays from the sun reach directly to the earth. The impact of this is very huge.
Some of the negative impacts of ozone depletion is climate change, destruction of food chain, crop failure, stunted growth of plants, premature aging, blindness, skin cancer, etc. Nowadays, the use of CFC is regulated in many countries. Other compounds are used instead of these harmful CFCs. There are many simple ways through which we can save our ozone. Here are they. Avoid buying and using aerosols and sprays made up of CFC. Avoid using fire extinguisher which destroys the ozone layer. Choose to buy a refrigerator or AC without CFC. Use alternative means of transport like buses, bicycles or walking, etc. Buy energy saving gadgets and bulbs.
We may think that what change is going to occur if we alone go for all these protection activities. Do you know who Greta Thunberg is? She is an environmental activist. The thing that we have to note is that she is just a 17-year-old girl. If her idea could spread the whole world, why can't we? Believe that even small thing can make many changes in the world.
In short, we all can contribute to do something for our environment. Thank you and have a nice day.